Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, we are going to make a 3D printable ring today in Tinkercad. You do need to know your ring size. I will have a link to this project in the description. Of course, you can open this and then download those STLs to print it so you can know your ring size as well. I'm going to be working with a size 10. Friends, we need to know that ring size. Remember, mine was a size 10, and this number 11.9 is the magic one that makes this all work. Once again, track down your ring size, and then we'll be ready to roll. We're going to build with the awesome tube. Remember, I said mine was size 10, so my number out here is 11.9. And press enter. The wall thickness is all calculated with a wall thickness of 2. This number here makes all of these work. Make sure you don't use a different number. Do set your sides to 64. I'm going to tell you a good bevel is 1. And I'm going to tell you the bevel segments should be 10 and press enter. Notice you get a nifty rounded ring size. I'm going to print mine at size 9. I also like to use size 8. You can pick whichever one you think is cooler. Of course, it is fun to pick a color. I'm going to go with the blue, and it's going to be a custom blue just because I like showing you where that part is. Friends, we're going to put our letters on first with brute force. I want you to get over here to sides, and we're going to just change this to 10. This gives us a flat spot to build a letter. Friends, we're going to make this make a little bit more sense by getting one of these edges straight with the lines. Because of our math, I know the number we need is 18 degrees. So rotate yours 18 degrees. If you miss, you can just type the negative 18 in the box, and it'll snap so it's flat. Now we can line this up with one of the grid lines, see how perfect that works. And then we're going to use cruising to put letters on all these sides super fast. So bring out a chunk of text. For the moment, I'm going to just put the letter A here. I'm going to make it a hole. This is what I call the living work plane. If you lose this, if you click right here, we can just bring it back by doing work plane and put it on that flat edge back there. See how it's inside that shape. Now we're going to do Alt Shift. So you're holding two fingers on Alt and Shift, and you're squeezing this down so it lands in the middle. Notice I got down to about 5.38. If you want to set your grid to 0.25, that'll let you adjust a little better. I'm also zooming in with the scroll wheel, using my arrows to line this up, just the way I want. If we want to make sure it's perfect up and down, I'm going to select them all, do L for align, and I want that just like that. Now we're going to push it in, once again with the work plane there, by doing control down arrow. I'm going to set it to 1 millimeter and do control down so it sinks in an entire millimeter. All right, everybody, I'm going to hit T for transparent so we can see how that is sunk in here. And watch how we're going to get these letters to every spot. So we're going to click this one and do Control D. We're going to hit C for cruising, and we're going to grab the dot, and we need to get it all the way to the other side. Well, I'm going to do it in two steps. So now I'm rotating. I'm going to hit C for cruising again, and I finally got it exactly opposite of the first one. I'm going to do the Control down arrow to sink it in, and I'm going to put the work plane back on the ground. So now we can look from above. They look really good. If you want to line them up, let's do L for align and make sure they're all middle just like that. Let's also do L for align again and make sure the height is perfect as well. Now, friends, this is where it gets magical. We are going to shift select those two holes. Notice looking at it from the top makes that a lot easier. And then we're going to do Control D. We're going to rotate 36 degrees. Or two of the 18s that we used a minute ago to set it up. Do not click anything else, just do Control D again and again and again, and you have all of a sudden got all your letters for your cool ring placed. How awesome is that? We can look at it from the top, we can see they're sunk in. I'm gonna shut off my transparency here. Bingo, friends, you have just made your awesome ring template. Now, I don't wanna break this, so I'm gonna grab it all, do Control D, and I'm gonna move it over here. So I've got one that I can always come back to, and I've got my custom ring that I'm gonna 3D print. Well, we need to put a phrase on it. I'm gonna put the roar. Notice all I do is click, click and change all the letters. I'm staying with all capitals. If there's a letter I want a blank, like this one I do, I'm just going to delete it. Because I've got my template, I can always come back to that when I want. And my R and my O. That one already was an A. And then finally an R. I have two blanks that I don't need. That is fine. Once again, this is awesome because we've got our template if we want to make a different one later. Now we click on our ring. And we change the sides to 64. Select it all. And we can do group to make our awesome custom 3D printable ring. Friends, how cool is that? Now, of course, friends, I do have other techniques. I do want to show you that you could switch all the letters to these choices. You can also, I'll bring this out real quick. If we search and we type script SCR, you will find this fun set of text too. Notice I made it a favorite so I can always grab it faster. This gives you a lot more fonts you can pick from. Same technique, you would just build another one of these by switching and putting the letters on it. And then I've got one more final gift I want to give you. Click on this and do Control D. Bring it over here. I'm going to make all the sides maxed from the get-go. This time we're going to type text. And check it out. There is a text ring we can use. Now I'm showing you both ways because they are both useful. This one can get a little tricky. Let me show you how it works. I'm going to switch to the font Major Snafu. You got a few of these to play with. I'm going to type my whole phrase. So here is my The Roar again. Notice it is huge. So what we have to do to adjust this is we make it a hole. We adjust the text gap. So this is how far it is between the letters. So I'm getting it so mine almost ends. That means there will be a little bit of the ring at the bottom. And then we're going to select these two, choose L for a line, make the ring the boss, and go middle and middle. Now we need to get this to cut in. So what we're going to do is we're going to make it much thicker. I don't know an exact number. You need to stretch that and adjust it. But see, that's quite thick. Then we're going to hold this down and do Alt-Shift. And we're going to shrink a corner till it cuts in. So you can see right here, if I let go, it's starting to poke out the other side. I'm going to set my nudge to a lot smaller so I can be more precise. And I'm going to do Alt-Shift so that that doesn't poke out anymore. There's where it goes too far. That's perfect. This is too high, so I'm going to shrink it a little. I'm going to select them both, hit L for a line, make the ring the boss, and I want them to be vertically in the middle, and let's group. This is a little more complex, so it takes a little bit longer, but bingo, there is another fun The Roar ring. Cuts in perfect and ready for 3D printing. Same technique as a minute ago, we're going to do Control D, and watch this. We can double click on this one. Click on that font, and we can switch to a different font. Let's see what it looks like with Bebis. It is likely not going to fit. See how it just doesn't stay? So we're just going to do that same technique. I am editing it. That's what the pink means here. And I'm going to do Alt-Shift to get it so it's cutting in the right amount. So you can see there it is cutting in. I just need to shrink it down so it fits. I'm going to choose right there. And now, friends, when I click somewhere else, after a moment, we have got another The Roar ring. Two different ways to make them. Of course, both techniques have awesome skills that'll help you in all your Tinkercad creations. Friends, now that you've got your rings complete, let's make sure you change the name to say ring with your initials. I'm going to put V2 on mine because I've made a few of these. We're doing this so that when you export it, you can tell whose it is. So if you're using this in a classroom, this is how your teacher knows that it's yours. Click on the ring you think is most awesome and choose export, and we want to export as an STL. I always put mine in my 3D modeling folder. You can see right here it says ring MDH with the version 2, and I can hit save and it's ready for your teacher to send it to the 3D printer. Now friends, remember when you wrap up any project, don't forget you can go to settings, pick an awesome color. I'm gonna go with one of these grays, and I'm gonna shut off the grid so that it looks nicer. At that point, I can return to the Tinkercad desktop, and you can share your creation with the world by hitting properties. Of course, make sure it has a cool name. Mine has a description mentioning that this tutorial is coming soon. And down below, you'll find other ways to reach me. Of course, friends, make sure you add some tags. If you want me to see the cool ring you created, you can type HLMT23. I search that tag almost every day. And of course, I will give you a reaction. Finally, make sure you make your design public. And then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. When you're done, you can hit save changes. Once you've done that, friends, it's so cool to click up on the gallery. Of course, the first thing you see are the staff picks. If you notice one of my designs, don't forget there will always be a tutorial in it. And of course, those reactions are appreciated. Note I am also highlighting new sweet designs down below. What I really like to do, though, is shut off staff picks, hit the grid so we can see many more designs at once, and of course take a peek at the cool things people are creating. That is a wicked cool submarine. Over here, I love the guitar. Check this out. Here is a bat that is breaking. That is a cool idea by Biscuit Bird. Well done. And finally, check it out right down here. This is the tutorial I just created. Of course, that tutorial will be here in a moment. And reactions are always appreciated. One other bonus, friends, if you ever click on my username, you'll instantly see all of my projects I'm working on. Right now, they are sorted by recent. You can also click over here and sort by reactions. Just remember, no matter which one you pick on, there is almost always a tutorial, and those reactions are appreciated. One other super quick note, make sure you check out the circuits. There are a ton of amazing lessons here. And of course, if you check code blocks, I have a ton of fantastic lessons there as well. Friends, as I wrap up, I just want to remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got a tab dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of awesome categories. And then below that, you can find my day one favorites and also useful starters. And then finally, the Tinkercad essentials. Friends, also at the bottom corner, I want to share the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Lastly, friends, don't forget the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.